and I am going to pitch it or hit a half shot, I think you'll have more success. The reason I'm going to have you do that is I'm going to have you choose different clubs. If you're not going to carry the ball very far and you don't want to roll very far, I would suggest you using a high lofted club like the sand wedge or a pitching wedge. In this situation, you set up pretty close to like a putt, but a few key differences. You'll choke down on your grip because this is the length of a standard club, sand wedge. It's not, it may not be as short as your putter. So you'll choke down on here, give you a better feel for the shot itself. But try to set up relatively the same way as you would your putt. The key will be your weight might be a little bit more on your left side than your putt. So maybe about 55-60% on your left side. Your hands will be a little bit forward. And from there, you're going to keep this position here, this Y that we set up with our arm, because your hands are forward. So you're going to keep that position all the way through your stroke, back and through. You will not hinge your hands up here like this. So that's why it's very similar to a putt. You'll just take a very soft stroke back and through, very little body movement, more weight on the left side because we actually want to come down just a little bit, but not a whole lot. So you'll set up just like your putter, kind of tall like this. You don't have to hunch over a lot. Just set up with your weight a little bit left, your hands in front of the ball, and then just take a steady stroke like you would putt this shot. Just back and through. And then if you have to hit it a little bit farther because the pin is more like halfway on the green, I would suggest maybe taking a little bit less loft, maybe like a 9-iron, that will carry about the same position that we're at, but it will roll farther, okay? But your stroke stays exactly the same. That way, we're not changing our stroke necessarily. We're changing clubs to have it go farther. So I'm going to pick the same spot about 3 or 4 feet on the green, set up the exact same way. I'm going to choke down again on my 9-iron here, set up like I was putting it. My hands are forward again. My weight's just a little bit left. And now I'm going to take a very steady stroke back and through. You'll see. So the ball landed about the same spot as my sand wedge, but it rolled a little bit farther, okay, because of the less loft. Then if the pin is a little bit farther back, but I still have the same amount of green to work with. Okay, I'm going to just take a 7-iron here. I'm going to land it still in the same spot, 3-4 feet on the green. Let it roll the extra distance that I need with it. Okay, same setup, same shot. So I'm always practicing the same stroke. Okay, I don't have to practice here. I don't have to practice there. I'm practicing the same stroke, choking down on the club, weight a little left. Now feel like if I putted this shot right here, all I did was change the loft of my putter to a 7-iron loft, and I'm just going to putt it back and through. All right, so I hope that you take away that you're going to address your chips more like a putt. All you have to do is pick the appropriate club to carry the fringe and roll out to the hole. If you have any questions, please give us a call here at the Mike McGetrick Golf Academy. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Good luck.